I never thought I'd be one of those people with a wild story to tell. You won't believe what just happened to me. I'm still trying to wrap my head around it. I'm 27, my fiancé Elle is 26. Elle and I met during her freshman year of college in the same dorm. I guess it was destiny or just bad luck, who knows. Turns out we live just two towns apart, so I became her personal Uber driver. Adding 20 minutes to my trip was no biggie. After a few trips and some school hangouts, we started dating. Our families are tight-knit, so we spilled the beans right away. I met her folks during those drop-offs, just quick hellos and how are yous. Our families clicked like Lego pieces, and our relationship flourished. I graduated a year before her, snagged a sweet job, and visited her whenever I could. When she graduated, she moved in with me since we both had jobs in the same city. 3 years in, I proposed and wedding bells started ringing. But wait, there's more. This is where it gets juicy. In hindsight, there were red flags everywhere, but I just thought my dad was being overly friendly. He'd call Elle all the time, and if I asked, they'd say they were planning some family shindig. One day, Elle was in the shower and her phone rang. It was Dad. I answered and he sounded like I just caught him stealing cookies. He mumbled something about Mom's birthday and hung up quickly. Looking back now, I feel like the biggest fool in Foolsville for not catching on sooner. On the day I found out, it was like any other day. Elle had Thursdays off, so she made breakfast for both of us. When I set out for work, she gave me a kiss and told me to have a great day. Halfway to work, I remembered I left some crucial papers at home for my 3 p.m. meeting. No biggie. I just swing by at lunch. Elle kept texting me sweet nothings. What's for dinner? Did the laundry? Should I hang it up? You know, the usual couple stuff. I didn't bother telling her I'd be home for lunch. Surprise visits are fun, right? I got home and I saw a car that looked suspiciously like my dad's in the lot. Whatever, maybe he was visiting. I walked in and boom, it was like walking into a cheesy soap opera. Clothes everywhere, moans echoing, it was like a bad rom-com. I stood there frozen like a mannequin, a cocktail of rage, sadness, and disgust swirling in my head. Finally, I snapped out of it and decided to film the scene. I picked up their clothes and chucked them into the hall, then filmed my way to the bedroom. Flipping on the lights, I caught them mid-action and surprise, it was my dad with Elle. He freaked out, scrambling for a towel and telling me to stop recording. I warned him to back off, but he didn't listen. So I clocked him on the jaw, his head bounced off the door and slumped to the ground. Elle screamed, and I calmly pointed the camera at her, asking if she was worried about her lover or had anything to say to her fiancé. Dad woke up from his nap on the floor, and I told them both to be gone when I got back, or the video was going viral. I told Dad he was dead to me and should go talk to Mom before I did. I sat in my car stunned until my boss called, wondering where I was. On my way, I lied, then drove back to work. I must have looked like a train wreck when I handed her the paperwork because she asked what was wrong. I brushed it off, saying I was fine. She noticed some blood on my collar, freaked out, and rushed to me. I casually said, "Oh, it's my dad's." Her confusion was priceless. I whipped out my phone and showed her the video. She sat there, processing not only was my fiancé cheating, but it was with my dad. She offered to let me take some time off, but I said I needed to stay busy. I slapped on a smile for the meeting like a true actor. Afterwards, my boss asked how I managed to keep it together. I shrugged and went to my office. Finally, I went home, alone for the first time in ages. Talking about this has been therapeutic, but I'm lost. I have no clue what to do next. One thing's for sure, I need to escape this apartment. No way I'm sleeping in that bed again. I need to get checked for STDs, and oh, I probably broke my hand punching the old man. What a crazy story. This woman discovered that her boyfriend was cheating and decided to make him pay by planning a savage revenge. Check out this video for the shocking details.